Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this is a new part of Wisdom Builders. This video is part of Esther's Ministries and thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. So today, a new Wisdom Builders, and today we're going to talk about Fermin. And you say, what? Fermin? What, what is the Bible talking about it? We will watch in a few seconds, because before I start, as always, this is the Word of God and please read it, because with it, a change is going to come if you read it. So anyway, the Bible speaks to us that we need to work hard. And I know for a lot of people will say, yeah, well, that's normal. We need, if you want to have something or you want to build your life, we need to work. But not only just work for once in a while, but we need to work hard. And I know so many people who think that life will just come to them, or that everything they do, well, just lay down in bed and just wait for things to happen. That is not how life works. We need to work, but we do not need to work because I also know a lot of people are busy. They are so busy with so many things, but it is not productive. So it is, you need even wisdom in the way you work hard. And the Bible is speaking that in Proverbs 6, that we need to take a look at the ants. And I know the ants, you will say, yikes, an ant is a tiny little creature. And I, please do understand, I do not want them in my house. These animals need to live outside their house. And please do not even, that they don't come up to my apartment or or in the garden where I'm sitting with my in my father's house. But anyway, the Bible is saying that we need to keep watch on them, and that we need to keep him see how they are doing it. So I will speak to you out loud. Chapter 6, verse 4, and this is what it says: give not sleep to their eyes, nor slumber to their eyelids. With other words, we need to work. Deliver thyself as a roe from the hand of the hunter, and as a bird from the hand of the fowler. But hear this. Go to the ant, thou sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise. So, when I walk to the groceries, I see sometimes a little ant just walking in front of me. And sometimes they have things on their back. And sometimes I see them with even wooden sticks on their back. Or sometimes with it looks like food. And because the Bible speaks about it, and when I see an ant, I will always watch what are the animals doing, because I want to learn, I want to grow, I want to put the advice of the Lord into practice. But here we go. I will continue. Go to the ants, look at, consider her ways and be wise. Here it goes. Which having no guide, overseer or ruler. And I've worked in a different kind of job setting, and I've seen so many people who are just working when their boss is walking by. You will see them first sitting like this, and then when the boss is walking by, they will see, oh yes, the boss is walking by. So, and that's stupid as well. We need to be the same. We do not need to have two faces. Just be yourself and work hard, as the Bible says. Okay, but it goes on. It provided her meat in the summer and gathered her food in the harvest. So this is saying that the ant is focused. It is focused and with purpose. It is not just running wild and running from left to left and to right. No, it is focused. With meat, to provide it meat in the summer and gathered her food in the harvest. So this is saying that we also need to work with purpose and with a goal. And not, as I said before, just to be busy. And because busyness is not, most of the time it is not productive. And here it goes. The last thing is what it says. How long wilt thou sleep, O sluggard? When wilt thou arise out of thy sleep? Yet a little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to sleep. So shall thy poverty come as one that traveleth, and thy want as an armed man. So the Bible is saying if we do not work hard with purpose, with a focus, poverty will set in. And this is so true, especially with young people. I know they go out a lot and then they will sleep in. They will sleep in till sometimes 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And it is such a shame, because you will lose your time. Because time, which is coming by, you will never get it back. So the time is gone. So please, what we need to do is consider your time wisely. Consider it wisely and work hard with a purpose. So if you do not know what your purpose is in your life, just Romans 12, verse 1 and 2 says that we need to be a living sacrifice to the Lord, transforming our thinking into the Word, and then you will know the perfect will of God. And He has a purpose for you. So even if you do not know your purpose, finding out what your purpose is also work. And sometimes it is hard work. Even Paul, who wrote the New Testament, said in, I know which scripture by heart, but he is saying that he worked harder than any other apostle. But just to know the Lord, and he went traveling. he started churches everywhere he went, and he worked hard. He didn't work hard to get the acceptance of God or to get His love. No. He just worked hard for a purpose. He worked hard to get His purpose done in this earth. So I pray that you will be blessed with this message and that you will consider that hard work is a good thing, and that hard work with a purpose, it is poverty will not set into you if you work hard and diligently. This is it for today. This was the Wisdom Builder. See you at the next Wisdom Builder. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Don't forget to read your words. Okay, bye.